I don't think it's any surprise to say that I love board games. In our Tabletop RGB series, we've streamed Tabletop Simulator, we've survived many fiascos, and we even completed the entirety of the Waterdeep Dragon Heist D&D campaign. I think there's so much in common between video games and board games that I made an entire video on just that topic. But a few days ago, something special happened. I got this in the mail. Stardew Valley, the board game. This is the crossover the gaming world needed. An incredible indie video game full of charm and depth, translated into a board game with dozens of mechanics and hundreds of pieces. This isn't Monopoly, Fortnite, or some other half-assed cash grab. Stardew Valley the board game is a full-blown, well-intentioned game of its own. And having just played it, I've got some thoughts. Before we dive into the board game though, I think we should recap on Stardew Valley the video game. It came out in 2016 as a one-man passion project by Eric Barone. In Stardew Valley, players are given a plot of land and a cozy farmhouse in a lovely little village. Each day, the player can choose to clear land and plant crops, or go fishing off the pier, or make friends in town. And as the game progresses, the seasons change, festivals happen, new buildings are unlocked, and you even fall in love and get married. Stardew Valley is an enormous game that is arguably the best farming RPG. I'm happy to report that the board game is very similar. Up to four players work together on a single farm, performing many of the same actions as in the video game. You can visit the general store to sell items and buy seeds, or buy a building, or milk your cows, or make friends. All of those exciting tasks are in the board game, but with dice and cards instead. In terms of structure, this is definitely a worker placement game. Each round you can choose to take only two out of a dozen possible actions. And as the game progresses, you build up resources and tools like hearts, coins, fish, crops, etc. The overall objective of the game is to complete all of your grandpa's goals, as well as unlock all the rooms in the community center by the end of winter. This is all probably sounding very similar to you, and that's because the board game borrows a lot from the video game. And that's not a bad thing. This game captures that same feeling of joy when you sell a big bundle of crops or make friends with a really cool villager. Even the inventory juggling and limited number of actions per day are there in cardboard form. But there are also some unique things about the board game that really shine. The game's main progression is controlled by the Seasons deck. Each round starts by flipping over the top card of the Seasons deck, revealing new events like gifts from a friend or a fresh batch of fish. There are also season end cards that hand out upgrades and control the overall pace of the game. But that Seasons deck is largely randomized. You don't know whether that next card is going to help you or hurt you. It could be a festival, or it could be the death of your crops. Grandpa's goals and the community center bundles are also randomized, which means the win conditions change every time you play. That means you have to work together to complete 10 different goals using a variety of resources. You'll have to strategize your actions and trade resources as you interact with nearly every game mechanic multiple times. Thankfully, there are ways to upgrade and improve both the luck-based activities, like fishing and mining, as well as your income streams, like crops and animals. If you maximize your teamwork and keep the resources rolling in, you might be able to complete all your goals before that last winter season card is flipped. Stardew Valley the board game is not perfect. The fishing minigame relies too heavily on dice rolls, and some of the resources are a bit limited in how you can use them. And the farming isn't as good as it is in Harvest Dice or Caverna, where you're building a big farm. In this game, your farm is a five-slot track that's constantly being cleared. But even with those complaints, this is still a very good board game. There's so much depth and variety in it that everyone can find something they enjoy. Our playthrough took nearly 3 hours, but we never got bored. If you like Stardew Valley the video game, or if you like cooperative games, or even agricultural themed games, or if you like board games at all, you should probably pick this up.
I hate Mario Party, but I know you love our videos. So why don't you like, comment, and subscribe, and you'll be able to tell when they're out whenever you want.